Let's talk about how you can control multiple lasers in QuickShow. With QuickShow, you can control as many 9 unique outputs. And I say outputs here instead of lasers because if you daisy-chain ILDA from one controller between different lasers, the output from those will be all the same, even if it's more lasers. That type of setup is known as shared control. If you have what is known as independent control, where each laser has its own laser controller, like our FP3 or FP4 control hardware, you can control up to 9 of them with QuickShow. If you need more control, you can check out our Beyond software, which can go up to 40 controllers with our ultimate version. To control lasers separately in QuickShow, we use several tools that exist inside QuickShow in conjunction with each other. To learn more about each subject, you can watch the related Quick Hints videos for these topics in the series. First, as you can see, I have 4 lasers connected to QuickShow. Down at the bottom, and here in the laser controller hardware window, these are FP4s built into the lasers I'm controlling, so this is the case. It's 4 separate lasers. First thing you will want to do is go to Settings, Projector Settings, and set them all up. The average user leaves everything at default, but makes the image size 100 by 100 for beams and 50 by 50 for graphics. If you're doing both, just use 100 by 100. Next, we will want to go to Settings, Projection Zones. If you don't see Projection Zones, you need to go to the Quick Start Wizard here and change your user mode to Advanced User. Now, in projection zones, we have a whole set of default zones designed to work mainly with one projector. When you're a user with multiple lasers, we recommend starting over with the zones completely and adding zones you will use and removing the ones you won't. So, I will add a scanner 1 main zone and delete every zone that isn't a scanner number main zone. This will leave us with just scanner 1, 2, 3, and 4 main zones for our 4 lasers. To move zones around in our list, we can hold Alt on our keyboard and click and move like so. On the left of the zone names, you'll see Projector 1, 2, 3, and 4 assigned. To the right, we have all of our hardware listed here, and we can change which projector a zone will output to. In this case, we'll use 1 for 1, 2 for 2, etc. Once that is complete, we adjust the geometric correction for each zone in real life to create a safe beam show setup. If you want more information on how to do this safely and effectively, check out our How to Safely Set Up a Laser Show video on the Pangolin YouTube channel. Now, we also could set up our preview window so that it looks like our setup in real life. From there, you can do inverts if you want by using negative size on both the zones and the preview values. When you're done with all of that, I recommend saving the zone file into a file you'll remember. This could be for your specific show that day or a setup that is permanent. Either way, you'll have the zone file ready to go and load it up if it ever goes back to default. Now that we have separate zones for each laser, we need to tell our content to go to those zones. Due to safety reasons, QuickShow won't automatically output content to zones without being told to do so by the user first. So what we need to do is go to the page of beam content and reassign the content that was originally told to go to a zone that was part of our default zone setup. And now go to our 4 new zones for our 4 lasers. To do so, we can select an entire page by selecting Ctrl-A on our keyboard, which will select them all. From there, you can right-click on any queue, go to Queue Properties, and click Destination, and add all of our new zones and remove any old zones from the list like so. Now every queue on this page will go to our new zones, and we can see it in real life, and set up in our preview window. It's important to note, we just reassigned this page of queues, so you'll need to reassign each page of the workspace when you create a brand new zone file. As well, you'll need to save your workspace file for QuickShow to remember the changes we have made. I recommend naming it based on what you named your zone file before, so you can keep those 2 files together. And that's how you control multiple lasers with QuickShow. The same process works for smaller or larger setups, and if you want to mix graphics and beams together, just make zones for the lasers you'll have to assign the content to those zones. Thank you for watching this video on how to control multiple lasers inside of QuickShow. If you still need help, you can contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com, and we'll help you as soon as possible.